despite the pandemic, we've still managed to get a decent amount of work done. A lot of our work has been through simulations and modeling, both numerical modeling and CAD modeling. Our airframe has definitely come a long ways since the virtual project update. This is the current status of the airframe, and now Katie, our team lead, will show you how it is.
So right now you are looking at the full airframe assembly, and it's divided into sub-assemblies. So the first sub-assembly is the nose cone system, including the nose cone tip and the carbon fiber module, as well as a coupling ring. It's then connected to the ERS system that has another coupling ring, and they're joined together with arc clamps. This ERS system is then connected to the RCS system, which is joined with arc clamps as well. We then have the nitrogen tank, which is the composite module laid up with carbon fiber and Nomex. Below that is the camera module. It also serves as a pass-through module to allow for components to pass through on the inside of the rocket. The module below that is the avionics module. It's also a composite module, but it uses fiberglass instead of carbon fiber. Below that is another pass-through ring. This pass-through ring will be modified to allow for any sort of connections that we need to happen there. Below that, we have the isopropyl alcohol tank, and that is made out of an aluminum module that has isogrids machined into it. Below that is another pass-through ring. You can see that the race pipe here connects the nitrogen tank to this pass-through ring. And we also have our topmost launch lug attached to the arc clamp. It's actually built in. Below that, we then have the liquid oxygen isogrid module. And below that, another pass-through ring. Again, all of these pass-through rings can be modified. Right now, they're completely plain and allow for the race pipes to connect. We also have another launch leg here as well. And then below that is the fin can module and another launch leg. And this system will be redesigned to ensure structural feasibility. And that's it for airframe.
All right, so what you have in front of you is a piping and instrumentation diagram of the internal propulsion system for LV-4. As you just saw in the CAD, we have our nitrogen tank labeled here, our upper isogrid tank for the isopropyl alcohol in green, and the liquid oxygen tank is in red. In between these, we have all the valves and sensors that we need to ensure that our engine is running properly. We start off by breaking it into pressure regulators set for the needs of each individual system. First, we have a pressure inline for the fuel tank. Each tank has both a pressure relief valve and a backup burst disc to ensure that overpressurization is not a failure mode for either of the tanks. We then send it down into the electric feed system, which then ramps up the pressure of the fluid, and the flow rate is regulated by these cavitating venturis below. We use the electric feed system so that we can keep our tanks at lower pressure and make them lighter. At the current design, neither of the tanks keep the propellant at above 75 PSI. We also have a purge line that runs from the nitrogen tank all the way down and can blow out excess in the chance of engine abort or after the standardized bird time has finished. We have our ground support equipment for liquid oxygen filling. That includes a double check valve and a pressure safety valve to prevent backflow into the Dewar, and then a fuel drain line to jettison fuel at apogee or on the test stand if launch is aborted.